Hi, good morning, all you wonderful people. This is Vidisha Vitlani, and I welcome you back to Aussie's group and wishing you a very, very happy Saturday. And I'm glad that you guys are here with me. And it is exciting to take this live lecture because it is one very small but very important topic that we're going to cover, and it's the format of the task one. So see, a lot of students actually have this thing that, what about task one? Like, why do we need to give it so much more importance? But see this, task writing component is basically divided into two tasks, okay? That's task one and task two. So task one is three bands. It's a letter or an, okay, for a general training. And for an academic, it's going to be a graph. For your task two, it's an essay. There are three bands for a task one. You have 20 minutes for it, and you have 150 words, which is your minimum count. Now, when I'm talking about 150 words as a minimum count, that means it is the least that you have to write, not the maximum. But however, don't go very long. Write up till 175 or 180 maximum. Because if you write overboard, you're going to miss out on timings, right? So that much is more than enough, okay? Again, when it comes to the task one, something which is very important is for you to understand that these are the three bands that you have in your task one are actually easy to score. Like, if I write my letter properly out of three bands, it is very, very easy to get around 2 or 2.5, which is obviously not the case in an essay. So if you want your overall score of writing to go up, you have to really work a lot on task one. Okay, so firstly, task one for a general training is going to be a letter, and for an academic, it's going to be your graph. So I'm going to describe both of them to you, but in parts. So firstly, I'm going to go with the general training. Okay, now talking about the general training, a letter can be of three types: formal, informal, and semi-formal. Now, obviously, what is a formal letter? A formal letter is something that you write for purpose of work to somebody you know or may not know. So, for example, if I am writing a letter to my boss for asking a leave, it's going to be a formal letter. But if I'm writing a letter to a gym manager for a complaint, that's also going to be a formal letter. I'm asking a restaurant to, you know, change certain things or, you know, expect a particular service, that's also a formal letter, right? The exactly opposite of a formal letter is an informal letter. What is an informal letter? An informal letter is something that I write to my friends or relative, right? Some, like, for random stuff. Like, for example, if I'm writing to my friend to invite my birthday party, that is going to be a formal letter. If I'm writing to my relative to ask him something or to ask a suggestion, that's going to be an informal letter. Okay, so that's the difference between a formal and an informal letter. Then comes the third type of letter. Now, which is the third type of letter? It's called a semi-formal letter. Okay, this is somewhere in between. Semi-formal letter is generally written to people you know, but for the purpose of work. So, for example, if I am writing a letter to my neighbor to make a complaint, that's going to be a semi-formal letter. If I am writing a letter to my landlord to make sure, you know, for a delay in payment probably, that's going to be a semi-formal letter. So there are three types of letters. I hope it's clear to you: formal, informal, and semi-formal. Now, why did I explain you these three types of letters? The format of all these three letters is the same. Okay, you're supposed to write this in the same way, but the opening and closing is different. Okay, the opening and closing is different. So when you begin a formal letter, you begin with dear sir or madam, you end with yours faithfully. When you begin an informal letter, you begin with dear and the first name, and you end with warm regards. And when you begin a semi-formal letter, you begin with dear and the last name, and you end with yours faithfully. This is the opening and the closing portion of it. Another thing, you have to be careful that in the semi-formal and formal letter, you can't use any abbreviations. You can't use don't, you can't use can't, you have to do that. So you have to write do not, cannot, something like that. So you have to be very, very, very careful. Okay. Now let's go on to the format of it. Now, talking about the format, the letter has to be divided into five paragraphs, right? The first paragraph is going to be the purpose. You begin with your opening, dear sir or madam. Then comes the purpose as to why are you writing the letter. That is very important. That one line will actually show the examiner that you have understood what is asked and you are going to reply exactly the same, right? So the purpose is very, very, very important. So you have to always write that I am writing this letter to, I am writing this letter for. Let's say I'm writing to my boss for a delay in payment. You have to write, I am writing this letter because I have a request to make, something like that. Okay, so the purpose is very, very important. Now, in your question, there will be three bullet points. Okay, you have to make sure that you include all the three bullet points, right? While including all the three bullet points, you have to make a separate paragraph. Paragraph 1 will take bullet point 1, paragraph 2 will take bullet point 2, and paragraph 3 will take bullet point 3. Then comes the closure. I hope you've understood my situation. I'm expecting a positive reply. That then you have your signing off. Yours faithfully, yours truly, something like that. Okay, so we have letters for five paragraphs. The first paragraph is the purpose, very, very, very important. Then comes your body 1, which takes bullet point 1, body 2, which takes bullet point 2, body 3, which takes bullet point 3. Remember, all these bullet points will be there in your question. And then comes the closure or the signing off. Yeah, it's last night I had something. Flavored food, so yeah, my throat is gone. I hope I'm audible though. So this is the format of it, and I hope you've understood the format. Okay, now see, a detailed version of this format is available with samples, with the differences, with what a formal and semi-formal letter is. All you have to do is you have to go to ielttutorials.online. You have to go to free webinars tab. You have to click on close webinars. Try searching something from around 6 months back, because back then we were in office and not working from home. So you can just find something from 6 months back and you will find a lot of those sessions. They will be entire. The length of those sessions would be somewhere around 30 minutes, 40 minutes, because they cover a lot of things. You know, they actually cover the whole my format, my pan descriptors, the sample, everything. So that is something that will be covered. So please do go through it. It is important. Or else I think you will also find them on IELTS Tutorials YouTube channel. You have to write IELTS in capital and then tutorials. You'll find us thing. You'll find us there. So definitely go through it. Yes. Now coming on to a very, very important portion. How are you judged? Basically, let's say I've written a letter. What all you need to consider while writing a letter? So as we know that there are four band descriptors. The first one is task accomplishment or achievement. The second is cohesion, coherence. The third is lexical resource. The fourth is grammatical range and accuracy. So how are you judged, basically? So my first band descriptor is my task achievement. Now, when you're writing 150 words, okay, that is your task achievement. When you're including all the three bullet points, that is your task achievement. When you're writing the purpose properly, that is your task achievement, because the examiner knows that you've understood the question, you're answering exactly what is asked, and you have a proper opening and signing, because now you also know that what kind of a question type it is. Okay, so that is something. Then comes your coherence, cohesion. As I say, it is nothing but structure and layout. Okay, now what I mean by structure and layout is that you have made separate paragraphs. Each bullet point takes a separate paragraph. There is no redundancy. There's absolute synchronization, and that you've added linkers in between. That is your coherence and cohesion. The next comes lexical resource. Lexical resource is basically your vocab. You're writing uncommon vocabs. Also, what you can use is collocations. Please make sure that the language for the formal informal letter is appropriate and you're using exactly those kinds of words which are required, right? Like, for example, I know that you are, sick is something that you can write in an informal letter, but I am aware of the fact is something that you can write in a formal letter, right? So these are the two, it's a minor difference, so lexical resource. Next comes your grammatical range and accuracy. As I always say, grammatical range is different, grammatical accuracy is different. Grammatical range involves you using all types of sentences, simple, compound, complex, active, passive, you making a merge of it. Whereas the grammatical accuracy is you being accurate in grammar, that there are no grammatical slips. You've actually just done, your tenses are right, your punctuations are right, everything is perfect. Okay? So I hope this session was clear to you, the format, the types of letters, and the band descriptor table, what you're supposed to do, what you're not supposed to do. And I hope to see you one more time next Saturday. So anybody who actually needs a quick session on a letter writing, please forward this small video to them. This would be really, really, really helpful. Meanwhile, please like, share, and subscribe. Also, if you need any help, IELTS Tutor is always there for you. We have online classes, we have webinars, we have test evaluations, we have mock tests. So any way we can be helpful to you, our one-to-one sessions are also on. Please do let me know. Bye, guys.